Welcome, and in today's video, we're going to be diving a little bit deeper into our immune systems and specifically talking about B cells and how their structure and function help us fight diseases. All right, so today we're going to be talking about B cells, which are part of our adaptive immune system. And our adaptive immune system is built to target specific pathogens, and it does this with antigen-antibody recognition. So on the outsides of pathogens, such as viruses, so here in red we have a virus, we have antigens that are on the outside, which are recognized by antibodies. So here in blue is an antibody, and so we see here that the antibody binds to the antigen, and when that happens, an immune response is signaled. Now, antigens are recognized by two main types of white blood cells or lymphocytes, and these are our B and T cells. And they're called B and T cells because the B cells are mainly within our bone marrow. So this is a cross section of the bone. And the T cells, while originating in the bone marrow, really mature within the thymus. And here's a cross section of the thymus. And today we're just going to specifically talk about B cells. B cells can really be categorized into two main types. The first of which are effector cells. So these are cells that are really aimed at fighting and killing the pathogen, mainly by producing antibodies. And then we have memory cells. So our adaptive immune system is the part of our immune system that memorizes pathogens. And so the B cells are really important for this because they help us remember the antigens and the pathogens so that if we see that pathogen a second time around, we're going to be able to fight it more effectively. So B cells are the only white blood cells that actually bind directly to antigens. And this is why they're sometimes referred to as antigen-presenting cells or APCs. Because they will present the antigen to other white blood cells, such as a T cell or a natural killer cell. So in this figure here, we kind of have our, say, like stem cell of a white blood cell, and it can differentiate into any of these. And then the B cell is also the only one that can then differentiate further with B cell cloning. And B cells have what are called B cell receptors or BCRs. And this is what allows the B cells to actually bind directly with the antigens. And so these are basically the B cell's own version of an antibody, which is built into its cell membrane. And so B cells are actually estimated to have over 100,000 BCRs on their membranes on average. And it's important to note that all of these BCRs on a single B cell are designed for a single antigen. So you won't get on one cell a BCR for one virus and then a BCR for another. So all the BCRs on a single cell will be designed for a single pathogen. Now, B cell responses can be in two different main forms. The first of which can be independent of the T cells, or they can also work with the T cells to have a response. So the T cell independent response starts with the B cell binding to an antigen directly. And it's important to note while these B cells can bind to antigens, it's only actually a certain type of antigens that they're able to bind with. And these are antigens that are not made out of proteins, but out of other molecules such as polysaccharides, so made out of sugars. Once this happens, a second signal is then called, and this calls in other immune cells such as complement system enzymes. You can learn more about these in the innate immune system videos that we have. And then once that happens, the B cells will actually clone themselves into a special type of B cell called plasma B cells. And these plasma B cells lose all of the BCRs on their membranes and then actually start to produce free floating antibodies. So the antibody-like BCRs are then removed, and then we have antibodies that are now floating in the blood plasma that are attacking the pathogens directly. Going on to the T cell dependent response. So this is a more complex response as it involves also the T cells, but it results in a stronger response in total and actually develops those memory B cells that I just talked about. Here, the helper T cells will help the B cells recognize and bind to a protein antigen. So while the independent response can directly bind to non-protein antigens, this is for B cells to bind to protein antigens. And so here we have the T cell in green, and once it binds to our B cell, then the B cell can bind to the protein antigen. And this is called linked recognition. Next, once this happens and the T cell helps the B cell bind to our antigen, a response is released. So here we have cytokines, which are shown in the little blue circles. So these are now released during this signaling, and this will activate B cells to then clone into those plasma cells that were in the T cell independent response, and then also into B memory cells so that it will memorize these antigens. That is it for today. I hope that you enjoyed this video. And if you want to learn more about our immune systems and our body or all living things and other biology topics, please subscribe for more.